Right now at 5, running from the law. Chopper 4 captures a wild police chase with even a crazier end that went well beyond your ordinary crash. Now, in this case, the robbery suspect kept on running, eventually hitting some snags along the way.
Among them, a fence and a couple of people who got the scare of their lives early this morning. CBS 4's Peter Dench is live in Miami with the breakdown of events here. Peter, take us through it.
Well, Cynthia, Miami police say it all started just before 7 this morning at the Starbucks restaurant behind me at Biscayne Boulevard and 68th Street. A gunman went inside and demanded cash. A terrified clerk gave it to him inside a bag. Now, fortunately, at the time, an off-duty Miami firefighter saw what was going on. He called 911. The suspects fled north on the highway. One of them ended up terrorizing people inside a Miami Gardens neighborhood.
I was petrified because I've never been a victim of violent crime before.
This victim, who was confronted by the suspect on the run, feels fortunate.
I am so grateful to the Lord for the presence of mind. I'm thankful I didn't fall.
She ran away from a man on a crime spree. Police say he and an accomplice robbed the Starbucks restaurant on Biscayne Boulevard. Their Toyota Camry was pursued northbound on I-95. The car spins out and crashes on the Florida Turnpike near the Golden Glades interchange. While one suspect is caught, another man gets out of the car and starts running down an embankment. We follow him as he scales this fence and then gets hung up. As he struggles, he drops cash. Then he starts running through yards and runs into this victim.
I looked up and then all of a sudden I saw him coming over the fence and he was hollering, "Give me your keys, give me your keys." And I looked again and both his hands were occupied, one with money, one was holding up the pants. So I didn't see a gun, and that would prompt me to run.
She said she did not want to give up her car keys.
And a quick decision, I just decided I wasn't going to give him my keys. I ran to my neighbor because all I could think was if he get me down, it could be worse.
She says he doubled back to her house after she left her house key in her front door.
And he went back and grabbed the house key thinking the car keys was on there. And he got in my car and he tried to use the house keys to start up the car.
That did not work. Then he is seen approaching another neighbor who was watching from her doorstep. After a while, he stops running and is seen walking around the neighborhood. Then he waves his hands in the air and surrenders to one officer. He lies on the ground until another one arrives and puts on the handcuffs. Now, the victim named Marilyn told me she drew on her experience as a former U.S. Postal Service employee to think quickly and take off. So far, Miami police have not identified the suspects. They are checking with other agencies to see if they committed crimes in their jurisdictions. We're live in Miami. Peter Dench, CBS 4 News.
Right now at 5, running from the law. Chopper 4 captures a wild police chase with even a crazier end that went well beyond your ordinary crash. Now, in this case, the robbery suspect kept on running, eventually hitting some snags along the way.
Among them, a fence and a couple of people who got the scare of their lives early this morning. CBS 4's Peter Dench is live in Miami with the breakdown of events here. Peter, take us through it.
Well, Cynthia, Miami police say it all started just before 7 this morning at the Starbucks restaurant behind me at Biscayne Boulevard and 68th Street. A gunman went inside and demanded cash. A terrified clerk gave it to him inside a bag. Now, fortunately, at the time, an off-duty Miami firefighter saw what was going on. He called 911. The suspects fled north on the highway. One of them ended up terrorizing people inside.